A warm welcome here, Laszlo.
Hi, Christian.
Hi.
I'm happy you made it.
Yeah.
Thank you very much for taking the time to do this live call. Disclaimer, I'm right now on holiday in Greece and I had to choose between very poor internet or some loud music and people, so I had to choose the latter. So if you hear some noises, it's just the way it's going to be this time. And yeah, let's start with you. You are the co-founder of Profit Wallet, and it's just a few words about you, and then I would say that we get into the presentation.
Sure. Yes, sir. So I would say I just mute you in the time I talked, and it's good, better for the talks. Thank you for the invitation. Thank you that we have the time. It's great that you'll be on holiday and taking the time to have a talk with us. So this, we're very proud to have you as a partner, to talk with you during your holidays. And thank you for the community. They are looking through the video and see what we are doing. So we are happy to going this way. And I tell a little bit about myself. My name is Christian Lenk. I'm a co-founder. So we are two co-founders from Profit Wallet. Another one is Alexander Ruck. This is my partner. We both founded Profit Wallet. I'm 47. Yeah, I got a family, child. Like everyone, I think this is something regular in my age. So I live in Germany, in Bavaria. So that is where I'm living. I'm in the space since 2016. So my journey starts very early. I'm in the financial business since 16 years now. So working in the investment part, I'm working with financial instruments. I worked in the part insurance and all the stuff. And so I'm doing this over 16 years. And in the year 2016, I get my first steps in Bitcoin. And from this on, there was Bitcoin. I bought my first Bitcoin at 511 euros. So this was a good time. And so I'm very happy now because I really don't care what's the price now, because people are a little bit angry and said, oh, Bitcoin went 70,000, now it's 25 or 23. I don't care. I always said I bought at 511. So I don't care where Bitcoin is, because I'm always in plus. So this is fine. But I know there are some people that bought last year at the highest prices at 43,000. The most people we know bought at 43,000. And this is not good when you bought at this time and now you have to wait to come back. But I think it's a good opportunity for the future. And so, yeah, I think Bitcoin is one interesting thing in the space. And because I found this situation in 2016, I got it getting deeper and deeper and deeper in the space, and I fall in this rabbit hole. And I said, oh, there is anything more. And there's another thing more. And then comes Ethereum, smart contracts, DeFi. Then all the gaming things started on the blockchain. And this was really crazy. And that was a little bit of journey. So, oh, there's a little bit more. So it feels like getting up in the morning and open the door and said, oh, there's another door, and going in this door in the floor and said, oh, there's another door. And so it's the feeling in crypto for me, because every day something new is happening in this space. And this makes it very attractive and very interesting for me. And that's why I love crypto. And so I get it from the financial part in crypto. And I took a decision 2 years ago to said, okay, I'm going full time in crypto. So that was the time I done all my things privately for me. And two years ago, I said, okay, 100% crypto. And I equipped everything else, give it to the teams, to people that work with me. I got some companies in Germany as well. And I gave up all the responsibility to people. They're doing it with the teams. I still got about 140 employees. They're working for me, but we got teams. They do it this now because I take my decision. This is, I think, something what is very interesting. If you take a decision, you have to do it. Don't talk about, do it. And that's a thing. And so we said, okay, I'm all in, and I'm going full time in crypto. And so we built a company, and this was really, really cool. And today I can show you what we built it, what was the experience for Alexander and me the last 2 years, and how we said, okay, how we started this and what was the end product. Because this was not that we said, okay, tomorrow we have a product, let's go. No, it was beginning. We started and said, okay, let's have our own experience. We're getting in DeFi, we're getting in mining, we bought mining, we bought DeFi, we're going in the gaming part, and we're buying in, making money, losing money, because you need the experience. That's what we done the last 2 years. And we know, okay, what is DeFi? How is it work? Oh, you need MetaMask. You've got different protocols where you get in, how you get in to be sure, to be safe. Oh, there are rug pools. There are DeFi protocols where the administration put a button and said, okay, you can pay in, but if you pay out, you got 100% fee. And yeah, when you push the button for payout, you do a payout, but you don't get money because on the protocol, it's 100% fee. And that were things what were very crazy the last 2 years to see. And this was good for us to see how it works, how you take care, what protocols are interesting, what not. In which protocols you're going, how you can do a better research on the things, how you be involved in the space. And this is something what was very, very interesting for us in the last 2 years, same as DeFi, as same as NFTs. So this is a whole new space, and we're very proud to be in very early and can use this. And this was all what we've done 2 years. Then we had the situation to say, okay, let's do it. Let's go in and make a product, because we talk with so many people, and so many people like you and everyone saying, wow, great place. Yeah. And in this place, in this space, there's so many opportunities with the DeFi, with the gaming, with NFT, with crypto as well, with mining. But how can I get in when I'm just a man or a woman that reading an half hour a week maybe about crypto, or I just heard about crypto, but I want to use it, but I don't have the time, not the experience. I can't do this. I can't do the research all the day. And so we said, okay, there's a market that's this great market. And we got on the other side people, they are interested in the market, but they don't have time. And so we take the decision and said, okay, it's great to have a product where people get an easy access. And when you use our app, our bot, then you got 7 buttons to manage all your portfolio. And this is great. You just need 7 buttons. You don't need anything you have to know. You just need your finger and your handy, and that's it. 7 buttons, and then you can do it. And this was something what is very important for us. They said, okay, anybody can now use this opportunity and go in, because everybody got a handy, everybody have Telegram, everybody can have the app and push the button, and that's it. And that's how we get in. And now I think we can move on in the presentation, and I tell you a little bit what we are doing, because now we talked a little bit about me, about how everything started, and I would go in a presentation. Or Lasse, if you got any questions, are there any questions till now, or is there anything you want to ask for?
Oh, well, good. Thank you for the presentation. I every time I hear you, I find out a piece of information about you and your journey. So we can get to the presentation. If there's something comes up, then I just pitch in.
Okay, great, wonderful. Okay, so I will share the screen, and then we go directly in the presentation. So just give me a short information in the chat, maybe when you can see the presentation. If it's in, just write in one.
Yeah, I can see it.
Oh, okay, oh, great, wonderful. Okay, so I have to say a little bit sorry, because English is not my mother language. So sometimes could be that there's a word not really correct, or I try to get it in the best way. But I think we can manage this all together, and yeah. Now we'll show you a little bit.
You're great. Believe me.
Okay. Much
great. Thank you very much.
Okay. Good. Thank you. So I would start now with the little presentation in English for Profit Wallet, and let's move in. And oh, this is the German one, and this is always good that we have a German one and start now in English. So just wait, we open the German one. I think this will be better for us today. So once again, so yeah, let's move on. Here is the presentation in English, and let's start with the presentation from Profit Wallet. So we got a disclaimer here. So this is very important. Everything we talk about you, it's just a presentation of a product. So this is no investment advice. This is no service we deliver here. There is the opportunity that you lose all your money. Why? Because this is crypto. We don't know what's happening tomorrow. So this is very important. Do your own research on all the things what we are telling you, and be passionate in this space. So we're doing all the best we can do, but we want to show you that there is a risk. I think it's a risk like in every asset, if you're going in stocks, if you're going in other things as well. So please be passionate in the space, but let's move on and let's show you how we work in this space to do good results and have a good product. And yeah. So when people are usually read about cryptocurrency, especially when they come to use it and they trade in cryptocurrencies, NFT, there is any time the situation that they think has a risk. And risk, like we talked before, is for the most people, okay, risk is lose. But I think, yeah, risk is not all the time losing. But the people in the minds got the situation that they always think a risk is lose. So the question is, and that's what we think about in Profit Wallet, how is it possible and how is the option to do a way to increase the earnings and low down the probabilities of a loss? And when you read this, I think some people say, oh, it sounds too good to be true. And but we think, yes, it's good. And we believe it's true. And I show you why it's possible to get returns and have a low risk. How we do this, or what we are doing, I show you in the project situation what we have. So Profit Wallet invest in different things. So we're going in NFTs, in DeFi mining, play to earn. And this is for us very important that we're going in different parts of the space, because not every part of the space is working well every time. And there are times you're going short term, and there are times you're going middle, or things you're doing long term. And that's why we're having a good portfolio, because we are in these different parts. So we're working with international service providers. So a lot of companies we're working together in DeFi, working in the mining space, are large companies, huge companies. So we work with one of the two biggest miner company in the US. They take care about our hardware. And we take a decision to take a large one and take a huge one, because this is very important for us. You got good contracts, you got good opportunities there. And that's why we're taking these decisions. And that's why we're always looking for big partners, large partners, partners they are long in the space, or they got a good opportunity. And this is something what is very important for us. So what is very important as well is that Profit Wallet allows you to make a return on a daily basis, 24/7. So this is I think a huge situation in the market, and this is, I think, an USP what we got here, because in the most projects you're going in, you have to be you have to do pay in, and then you're locked for about half year, 1 year, 2 years. And here you got the situation you can participate in the market, and you get in returns, and you got the possibility as well to take money out if you want. Yeah, we think sometimes there is a situation. You said, okay, I need money. Then you need to have a possibility to do a payout. That's possible, and that's what we like in the project. Yeah, but we are on the long term, so we say, okay, if you need it, yeah, you can do it. But from our perspective and how we go in the next 3, 5, 7, 10 years, we don't see any situation that we have to do. Because I think it's much more better to build up now for the next years. I think that's a much more better situation than just do a fast pay in and a fast pay out. Because this is what people don't understand. A fast pay in and a fast pay out don't make any sense. Because only the long-term holders will hold on and will earn money. So it's the same when you look at stocks and things you're holding for a long, long, long time, then you're making money. It's like coins. Yeah, you can board, like me, I bought Bitcoin at 511 euro. And that was at the beginning. I don't care. And I have to wait till 2030 where Bitcoin is going. So the long term will be paid. And that's very important. And that's important in this presentation as well, and it's in our project as well. So I'm going in the first part, and our first part is the NFT and gaming part, and I think this is a very interesting part. In the last 3 years, we had a huge situation that gaming is changed, and we had like a catalysator, because people are sitting at home between in the corona time, and they don't have anything to do. They don't have a job. There was nothing outside. The government says you have to stay at home. People are sitting at home for 6, 9, 12 months and don't do anything. Countries like the Philippines had a problem. No tourism is coming to the people. No events, nothing. Nobody is coming to the Philippines and making holiday or something else. So people sitting at home don't have an income. I got some people. The parents are regular in Dubai and working in Dubai. So between Corona, they don't have the situation to stay to earn money because they can't drive taxis in Dubai. So they stay in the Philippines and have to be there. And they find something new to earn money. And this was the time Axie Infinity was starting. Axie Infinity was the first play to earn game where people invest money in an NFT. They hold a gaming a figure, they held an icon that they hold on the blockchain and they can play with, and they can earn money with gaming. So there were 3 Axie you needed, and then you can play. And people started to do this. There were huge guilds, people, they doing this. And yeah, this was the first movement, I think, in the play to earn. And after this, a lot of different games coming as well and say, okay, let's produce more games, more games, more games. Let's go on the blockchain. Why are they going on the blockchain? Why was this very interesting? Because there were 2 opportunities. There were people that say we want to earn with gaming. And you can earn with gaming if you have the money to invest in the game, or you investing in icons or in the NFTs of the game. Then you can earn money because you hold it, you got an ownership, and then you earn money when you play. But on the other hand, there are some people as well, they don't have the money to buy in. And here, 2 groups of people find each other in the universe, in the space, in the crypto space. Because people, they have money and they bought items or bought NFTs, because the items are NFTs. And on the other hand, you've got people, they don't have money, but they want to play and want to earn money. And these people are meeting each other because the one got money, one not. But on the other hand, the one that don't have money have the time. So the one person invests the money, the other one the time. And they both together have now the situation that one person is playing and another one is the guy that belongs the icon. And so they can play. And because the person that brings the time earning about 10-20% of the revenue, what they're earning with this game. And this was a good thing. So a lot of people can play without putting money in a game, and they don't have any risk just the time they bringing in. And this was the beginning of a new movement. And now you got a lot of games where you can buy the assets and play for yourself, or you can say, okay, I buy the asset and I give it to someone and he's playing and he don't have to buy. He don't goes in risk. And this is a good situation for both sides. And you can scale this and make money on this because when you got 50, 100, 200 people there are gaming your games, your assets, yeah, this could be very interesting. And so a lot of games are coming in the market and will come in the future. So we will see in the next 3 years Star Atlas as a very, very crazy space game. Yeah, they're building on Solana, and this is great. So they're building since 2 years now, and we think another 3 years. So it took 5 years until this project end, but it will be a huge, huge, huge game in the future. And people will earn a lot of money. They invested now, and they will earn a lot of money in the future. Same as Illuvium. Illuvium was building and is coming at the end of the year. People are earning Ethereum by playing the game. So they bought in the game, bought land, and now they're earning money because playing, people are running over the land, playing on their land. So this will be very interesting in the future. And so we see a lot of different games as well, like Alien Worlds was a mining game, Pickaxie was a running game for of English horse running game. Sometimes I'm sorry, my English and German, sometimes you have to think about. So it was a horse game, so it was great, and we got Ember Spirit. So a lot of things are coming, and I think this is very, very huge because the space is very huge. And here you can see how huge this space is. Just in February, only in February, $722 million were invested from venture capital investment companies in the space. So Binance, Solana, Ember, Brink, Animoca Brand, Polygon. So this is all companies. They are invested in the space. So this is really, really, really great. And when we see at the whole picture and you see, okay, in the whole last year 2021, where we had a bull market, where all the people were gaming and it was huge, everybody was in crypto, we had just 4 billion that were invested in the blockchain gaming space. So when we look at this year, and we can see the first quarter of the year was 2.5 billion, the second quarter was 2.5 billion, so we got 5 billion that invested in the first half year. And we think that in the whole year, so these are the data that shows us now how we are, where we are going, so we will have 12 billion that will be invested in the space. So this is three times more than in the bull run last year, and now we are in the bear market and we're investing three times more. So just imagine, think about what could happen in the next 3 to 5 years when everything goes up again, we are on the next bull run. Yeah, happy, happy, happy space, I would say. Yeah, this will be really great.
And if the venture capital companies are investing, they're expecting a profit, they're expecting some revenues. So this is also a clear sign that this, the space itself is interesting enough for big companies to invest big money and expect some returns.
Yeah. All the big money, all the big companies are investing and going deep, deep, deep in the space. And when you listen and just look what's happening in the space now, just we can talk about the last week. So in the last week, we had the largest investing company in the world, BlackRock, offers all the institutions, companies, all the institutions, they're working with them, the opportunity to buy Bitcoin directly on a direct link to Coinbase. So this is great. So they can buy Bitcoin now on Coinbase directly in the system from BlackRock. And 2 days later, BlackRock said, okay, we do our own crypto fund. And this is crazy. The largest investment company in the world. They are consulting countries and large companies and everyone, and they're starting now to build, to go into space. I think this is a sign. Yeah, they wouldn't do, like you said, they wouldn't do if they don't know anything, and they would say no, it makes no sense. I think they know things we don't know, so I think it's a good time to get in. Yeah, the second part is very interesting as well, because we have the NFT space, and NFT is a new model, new market. And I think the good thing in NFT is two things. So this is the ownership, that you can own things and you can sell it, like you have it in the traditional way. You bought pictures, and if you bought a picture, you can sell this picture as well. But here you got a digital stuff. You can sell it very fast on a digital way. And the good thing is that in the time we had Corona, things are changing. If you know people, they got money, they bought a car, they bought a Rolex, and they drive the car through the city to show what they have. And through Corona, nobody was outside, nobody can see, nobody can show what they got for money. And so things are changing. And people saying, okay, let's buy NFT stuff and do the NFT as a profile pic on my Twitter or my Facebook or Insta or wherever. And that's what's happening. So people see, oh, what he got on his profile pic, and they know how expensive it is. So it was a transformation of a thinking, I would say, because years before they're driving a large car, but I think in the future they will do as well, because Corona ends and pandemic is over and people going out as well. But the thing is changing and people buying this. And the next thing is, it's not only people buying it for the profile pic, then a revolution started, because people say, okay, maybe this is interesting as well. Let's get in and buy it. Don't buy pictures. Don't buy other stuff. Buy this. And this was something what is new. And the Board A Yacht Club, what you can see here, I think it will be one of the largest games, because they made so much money with the apes, with the game one day, with the sell of the landscapes, that what they are doing in the game. So I think this is be huge, and I think in the future this is something what we will see, that the Board A Yacht Club, the apes or CryptoPunks, that they all are growing in the price. Why? Because more people coming in the space, more people getting in, and I think we will see higher prices in the future. And we think this is very interesting. This is like, look back in the times where we have a Monet. Nobody wants to pay something for a Monet. And today, yeah, people paying a lot of money to have a Monet. And I think we are here in a space that is doing the same. And the good thing here is, and this is the ownership situation and the royalty situation, because if a CryptoPunk is sold or a different picture is sold, the creator of the picture getting money every time it's been sold. And I think this is a very good thing for creators. And I think now creators earn money, because a lot of creators, they created good stuff. Someone is buying, and then the people making money because they're buying to someone else, and the creator didn't get money. And I think this was a good thing we had here in the NFT situation, that people that created stuff, they get it. Royalties, they will be paid in the future for every time a sale of their a product is done. So I think this is a good situation what we have here in this space.
And excuse me for a sec. And the status symbol which NFTs became is only one part of it, because there are a lot of there are smart contracts behind. There are a lot of services behind. So if you have an NFT, then you get a lot of services from a company. Companies are releasing NFTs where the main objective is all the services behind it and all the products. And if you have an NFT, you have certain privileges in the future and so on. So this it's something that is exploding, and we don't have the idea what this is going to become.
Yeah, you're right. So I just showed one part. I think this is crazy, and we bought some stuff where we are part of a company, because company using this this tool as well to collect money and build good ideas. So this is great, and this is, like you said, it this is very, very interesting. And I think everything will be on the NFT situation. So I think all ticketing, so if you go to a soccer game or something else, you buy your ticket as an NFT, you use the NFT in your wallet, you show it when you're going in the game, or you can't go to the game, then you sell it to someone else. So you got a secondary market, you can go sell it, someone can buy it and go with the ticket to a game. And this is great. And you don't have the black market in the middle. I think this is a way. But maybe the soccer club getting more money, because if the ticket is sold once again, they're getting the royalty. I think this is something cool what's happening. And I think the same is happening, like when you buy a flat or something, yeah, then it's the same situation. Now you got a lot of papers, you have to go to the governments, and the government has to write what you're bought and to who belongs to who, and what is the situation with your flat. And now I think this is changing as well, all the things, but this takes some years. But like you said, everything will be tokenized. And I think this is a good opportunity to have things they are tokenized. So you can sell maybe a part of your house, of your car, and you can say, okay, I sell to someone a part of a house maybe, and this in a fast way. So I think this will be huge. I think the opportunities, like you said, with a smart contract in the back, what you can do is great. Yeah. Now we have, you can say, okay, I need 1 million to build a company. Then you create an NFT, having 1,000 NFTs, people paying in, you get 1 million, you can buy your business. And then you can say, okay, every holder of the NFT getting a reward every year, because you're a holder of the NFT. And so you're a part of the company, and they pay you every year. So that this could be something what's happening in the future. And I think a lot of things will going on this way. And I think so, we are just in the beginning here of a really, really new situation.
Yeah? Like a GoFundMe campaign, but much more complex and much more interesting.
Yeah, yeah. So this is great, yeah. So, I show you just a little bit, because we're talking a lot of the stuff now, what's going on. I want to show you what are the games of the second half quarter. And there you can see there are numbers going down a little bit in some games. In some games, numbers going up. And I think this is because the market was not so easy in the second quarter. Crypto is going down, was not so attractive for a lot of people. So this is always the same. Yeah, people coming in, people going, but if the price going down, people just a little bit scary. And that's what you can see on the numbers. But it's not bad, because the numbers can rise again. It will rise again in the future. But if anybody talks again, if the prices are rising, everybody is here again. It's like always. It's like in every business. And now you can see there are people playing Splinterlands, and Splinterlands was in the second quarter. You had a daily 283,000 people they playing Splinterlands, or 180,000 playing Alien World. So this is a huge situation. You can see if a game is starting, they get a lot of attractivity and a lot of people coming in. And you can see Gemeta, 19,000 people, but they just started then and they have 900% plus. And you can see this is a huge market. If people are getting in, if games are getting attracted, the numbers are rising. And then you got a lot of daily players. And yeah, this is something what is very interesting. So we for ourselves have the same situation. So we buy for the community NFTs in the gaming port, and we have gamers on the other side, and they're playing with our NFTs. So we got 300 people, they're working for us. So they are getting the opportunity to play with us. There are times we were getting more players, times we were getting less. So it's always about 300, and they take a decision how much they will do. So in times when we when the market is high, like last year, it was huge. They playing the whole day, and when markets are not so good, it's a little bit less. But for us, this is just a part of the whole portfolio, and we think it's very interesting to have a bunch of people. Then when we got when we got games, they have to be played. That we have people, they do this for us, and so we get a sharing, like we talked before. They're getting 10-20% of the revenue. 80% of the money we're earning with this is going to the community, and so going to you. Yeah, then we're in the DeFi space. I showed you the pictures. DeFi will be the future. Everybody is talking about DeFi. DeFi is the second largest market in the world in the growing part. And this is very, very, very crazy when you can see the numbers. And you can see from the last year, from 2022 beginning, so at the end of 21 and 2021 and the beginning of 2022, we had over 300 billion that was locked in the system. Now we see a lot of money is flowing out of the system because of the money, of the prices, of the courses that's going down, people taking money out because the markets are not only the crypto markets, older markets are a little bit damaged. And but the other side, and this is what is very important for me, is there are about 100 billion they're working in the system. And this is the second system that is just starts to grow. And you can see how fast it's growing. And next time when we have the next run, I think, yeah, this will be huge if all the institutions come in and bring the money in. I think this is just a part of a regulation. So if we got a regulation in the space from the stable coins, and I think in the US this will happen this year. So everybody thinks about that the US will be going here forward. And if we have a regulation on stable coins this year, I think this will be huge, because a lot of people see, okay, there's a regulation. Okay, it's a regulated market. We know how to work in this market, and then the money will flow in. And I think there will be a really inflow of money, and this will be very interesting for the space. And that's why we're thinking, yeah, this is very positive for the space, and will be have a lot of opportunities. I show you here some projects and different blockchains. So there are different blockchains, and on every blockchain there are different projects running. And you see what is going on in the project, how many money is locked in the project, and how it's moving. And you see if the market is moving again. There you have 7-day moving from 20% and more, like you can see here. I think this is something what we see. If the markets are running, they're running fast. And so this is, I think a very cool space. And yeah, we can make good money in this space. Why we can make money? Because in this space, you earn money when you give the people liquidity. So if there are people, just as an example, they coming in the space and said, okay, or they have the situation that they say, I got two currencies and I want to change, like they had it before. When you have a bank, you're going on a bank and you change from one currency to another currency, the bank making money. In the DeFi space, it's different. In the DeFi space, it's the situation you as a user, you provide liquidity. That means you give liquidity in the system, you give one coin or two coins in the system, and if people want to change from one coin to another, they can use your liquidity. And because they're using your liquidity to change, you're earning fees. So the project is earning fees, and you're earning a part of this fees as well. And that's why, and this is how you make money. So this is just one part. There's the part lending. So if you say, okay, I got money, I have Ethereum, maybe I give Ethereum in the system, and someone is lent the Ethereum, borrow Ethereum, then I earn money as well. And I think this is a good situation so that you don't go to a bank and the bank is earning money. Now here's the same situation. You can lending and borrowing on a decentralized platform, and the people that offers the money or brings the money in and give the liquidity to the people, they can earn money. So I think this is a good situation what we have here, and this will grow, this will go in the future in different parts as well. And I think this is a good opportunity to earn money in this space. The last part, maybe what's interesting in DeFi is the part staking. Maybe you heard before, you got the possibility to stake. Stake is the same like you had it before when you have a bank and you have a bank account and you got money on your bank account. Maybe you got $10,000 on your account. Then you get an interest from the bank. And at the end of the year, you earned a yield. So you're getting something from the bank because you give them your money and they can work with the money. And the same situation you have here in the crypto space. So that means you buy a cryptocurrency, then you stake it. So you give it in a system, in a protocol, and you don't move it. And because you don't move it, there's more stability for the coin in the ecosystem, because not the price is not going always up and down and up and down and up and down, because it's more stable. Yeah. So the crypto market is volatile. So that's why it goes up and down. But it's through staking, a coin have a lot of coins locked, and people people using this as a stability. And you earning on this, you're earning and yield. And this is great. So you got projects, you're earning 7-8% a year or 10% a year just for holding the token. And if you believe in a project, it's good to hold the token and getting a reward as well on 8 or 10%, because you love a project, love a token, and getting money extra. So I think this is the DeFi space, and this is, I think, very, very, very cool. In this space, you got a lot of opportunities as well. So you can have two stable coins. As you have a stable coin, is always a coin that has a worth of $1. So it always has to be about $1. And here you can see just in this case, there was Outer Farm here on the BNB chain. They offered on one day 18% if you're putting two stable coins on this wallet. So this was just on this day, was just a week where they had the good opportunities. That's what we are saying. It's not that you're going somewhere, put the money, and it's always the same. No, you have to work on this. You have to look, is tomorrow a better opportunity? Is it changing? Are the rates going up, down? So this is something what we are doing in the back to check what is the best opportunity. And so you don't have to do this for yourself. So this is the space, and this is an interesting space. So then we're looking at the Bitcoin mining. And when we started, we said, okay, we want to go into Bitcoin mining because we were fans of Bitcoin. We are fans of the cryptocurrencies. And if you're a fan of cryptocurrencies and you believe in the space, I think a part of your investment has to be a mining part, because this provides liquidity to the system. It gives the system the situation that you run a node, or that you the validation, or that you do in this part mining, that you provide the security of the network in the Bitcoin mining, and you take care about the transaction from the users. So if someone is sending Bitcoin from A to B, so they need the miners, and so it's good to be a part of these miners and earning a part of the revenues, the fees, and the part of the revenue if you get a Bitcoin on the mining. So I think this is interesting. So just in small words, and why it's very interesting, it's regular in the last year when the mining was on the peak. Everybody wants to mine. Bitcoin was very high, and if you want to buy a hardware mining rack, then it's about $12,000 to $15,000 for this what we are buying. And this is very important to know, because it's 12 to 15,000. And then you have the situation, you have to wait for 6 months to get a delivery. So that means you order, you pay the half of the costs, then you wait 6 months, and then you pay the second half of your delivery when it arrives. So now we got a situation, market is down, nobody cares about Bitcoin mining, Bitcoin is not interesting, it's always the same, people need money. And so what's happening now, a lot of miners are ordered, but now there are people say, I can't pay the second half, I don't buy it, I want to give it back, I don't need it. So now what is happening now? Now you have a market where you can get miners. You paid last year $12,000 to $15,000. Now you can get it for $5,000. And this is great. This is a huge opportunity, we think. And last month, the things are changes once again. You're getting miner for $4,400. Yeah. So once again, because we had really, was the down. I think it was one of the baddest days then, and I think was capitulation in all fields, I think. This was really cheap, and I think, and we think, this was a good opportunity to get in and board this stuff. And have it in the long-term situation, because now you're getting it for a really cheap price. Now we got a situation, we have a delivery time from 2 months, because they are still in delivery. So in two months, it's working. And this was good for us. And so our decision to go in was good. And we don't take the 5%, we take the 10%. You saw we just planned 5, and then now we're at 10% of the portfolio. Because I think the market as well is good for this, because we think, okay, now it's a good market to get in, because if everybody's crying again, Bitcoin is up, everything is rising, I think this is the baddest time to get in the mining. Now it's a good time to get in, and so we take decision. So now you can see we got this is the allocation, and we got 15% in DeFi, we got 10% in mining, we got 20% in NFT, we have 30% in play and earn, and we hold 25% in liquidity. Liquidity is the part where we have on the sideline for do the payouts, because we told you that there's a possibility that you can pay out your money, and that's what we have to secure. And so we have a part of 25% of our allocation is the part, the liquidity part, you can to pay out you if you want to have it, or if you need it. And so this is what we have here. Yes. I would say that's everything from the presentation. Everything else, I think we can do in a call. We can do it in our questions. And yes.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much,
Christian. Yes. Yeah. So we got some stuff in the just for you. So I'm just.
Still got some time.
Questions. Yeah, sure. I just want to say, so there are some parts in the presentation as well. You can download, see it in the when you're going on the app, on our app, and when you're on the part support, then you see a link tree, and in link tree, you get access to all the stuff, to all the data, to all the presentations. So in the presentation, there is a just part from for us as well, where you can see how is the money flow working. But I think I told you a lot of this stuff now, and then we got a small part in, so if you have a referral, so that means if you like what we are doing and you tell someone else, okay, hey, you can do this as well, then we give a small part of the money we are earning, we're giving in this part as well to the people. And this is what we are showing here. But I think this is now the important thing, because for us is the main thing is the investor, the people they're getting in, they're the important one. And that's why we want to talk about this today. because yes, the investor is always the person in the middle, and everything what we are doing is just for him or her. So this is the main thing, because network is just working with the people. Company is just working with the investor. So this is always the important thing. And I think a lot of companies think different. A lot of companies outside think, I need as a company the most money. Oh, the people, they bring me the customer, they need the most money, and I have to give the more benefit. And we see it in a totally different way, because we think the investor is the important person in this whole puzzle. Yeah.
That is also one of the things which I appreciate most about Profit Wallet, that it's focused on the existing client. You don't need new people, you don't need new money. You're just looking out for the ones who are investing, and they are having their returns. Everybody's getting their returns, and there's no push, there's no need for growing, for make a team and so on. It's a possibility, it's an option, but your focus as a company is on bringing the most value to the existing investors, not focusing your attention on marketing stuff and so on.
Yeah, absolutely. So I think that's what you're saying. So yeah, it's both. It's important to grow. You have to grow. But I think and that's what you said. We take care about our clients we have, and if they are happy and say, "Wow, great, we have a good journey. Now we're having good 4 months. They deliver. They're doing what they say. Everything is possible. We have people that try to get in, try to get out. So they do payment and pay it out to see if it's true, if it's true or not. And this is good. And then they say, okay, it's working. And then they call us and said, oh, that's bad. Now I pay the fee for pay in and pay out. So yeah, so that's like it is. So that's a part of how we make money as well for the company, yeah, to have a fee. And we don't want to get this, we are not a trading bot or something. People can go in, go out. So that's nothing we want, because we buy assets, and in the worst case we have to sell these assets, and we lose money, and that's what we don't want. But we have the opportunity that people get in, and I think people get out, and that's good.
That was also one of the first things I did, because I was told that I can get my money out at any time.
Yeah.
So okay, it will cost me some money, but I have to see that, and I'm click, and then after a few minutes, my money's there. Damn! Now I lost on the fees.
Yeah. Okay, but
I had my confirmation. I was looking for.
Yeah. I think so, this is but it's an important part to train this to check it. Is it working? And because we were talking a lot of different companies, so we don't want to talk about different companies. But I think the situation in the space, there are people asking, they have experience in the past, and they always need this confidence, trust, I would say. Okay, is it okay? Are they just talking, or is it really possible? And so in the most times they say, okay, let's pay in, and in 1 year you get your money. Yeah, we know the space. In a half year, the most companies are not here anymore. So it's nice to have something you say, okay, you give me your money, and in 12 months you get it back. So I think this opportunity what we are building here is good, and this is something what we want to tell the people, because I think we have a good return. So this is what we think with this option of a payout. So this is always what you have to have in your mind. So like you saw on the picture, we have 25% of the money we get is not invested, is it, and it's not working. Why? Because you can do a payout. And this is something people don't have in the mind. Yeah. Because they always see, oh, there are people, they give me this percent and this percentage and this percentage. And I think at the end you always have to look apple with apple. You know what I mean? You can't say, okay, I got this here and there I got only more results, but I can't get my money. And this is something, you know, you always have to check what you're talking about. And this is, but this is something we like. And I think that's why it is like we do this. Yeah.
You already have much better gains and returns than any other financial product on the market besides the crypto market. And you are actually doing it with 75% of all the money. So that's if you true. Would have invested all the money, not having anything in liquidity, then much bigger. But this is part of the responsibility that you were assumed yourself as. And yeah, this is a great part. And thank you for your presentation. And yeah, when I was telling people about this great project, I got a lot of questions. And it would be nice if you could help me answer those. Coming from you, it has much more power, and perhaps you have much more knowledge about all these issues. And yeah, the first one, we were talking about crypto, we were talking about blockchain. What is actually the difference? Because blockchain is a technology, crypto is just something running on the blockchain. And it's much more complex. What's your input to this?
Yeah, I think the blockchain is, like you said, just a technology. So there are different blockchains, and every blockchain, so every coin, we call it layer one. And there are different coins, and these different coins got their own blockchain. So see it like there is a blockchain, could be you only have a blockchain for yourself. And all what you're doing in your business is writing on this blockchain. Yeah, it's like you have it when you have. So that's what would I say, how I would say the blockchain. So and now we got different blockchains in the space. Ethereum got a blockchain, Bitcoin got a blockchain, Cardano, AVAX, Solana. So these are all blockchains. So, and in every blockchain, every coin is writing in what is happening in, out, exchanges, whatever, or what is going on, every buy, every sell. And that's what is on the blockchain, or if there's a burn because they're burning tokens and whatever. And this is for me the situation. What is a blockchain? And crypto is for me everything over. So because crypto is not only the blockchain, because there's a blockchain, and crypto is for me the blockchain, is the coin, is the NFT, is the situation, is the space, is the people they are working in, is the developer. It's the whole market. It's the exchanges, the decentralized exchanges. So this is for me crypto. So this is all over. And you are crypto, I am crypto. We are all crypto because we are a part of this economy, of this movement. And the blockchain is just a small part that brings things to running on a special coin, I think. So that's what is my think about what is crypto and what is
And a lot of people, me included, bought some coins not at the right moment, and now we're in the loss, and a lot of people had FOMO, fear of missing out, and bought some coins and then lost most of the value from it. How can we be sure that your investments are better or safer? Or
I do it in a hard way. I think the most people don't like it when we do this and we give it in a hard way, but it's the hard way, it's the real way. We don't know. There is no better way, because we're taking decisions. We do a good research. But if we take a good research and we think what's the best way to get in, so the fundamentals, then they are right. But if the market is going down and Bitcoin is falling to $2,000 maybe, yeah, all the research, all what we've done is nothing worth. Why? Because if the market is going down, you can have a good research, but I can't do anything on the markets. You know what I mean? So nobody of us know what is going up, what is going high. So we can only go in the market and say, okay, what's going to be the next 3, 4, 5 years, 10 years, whatever. And so we got a plan for us to see, okay, we are a long-term investment. And one thing what is very important is, if you are in crypto, you know there is a cycle. And we know, don't care when you invested. Don't care if it was at the highest price, whatever. Don't care. After 4 years, you always got the same price, or you're over the price you bought. So it took 4 years. This is something you can see on the pictures, because these were the cycles of the last times. It was an always 4 year cycle. And then you'll be in the same part. So that means, like we saw, and the data Glassnode gave us this information 1 week before. the most Bitcoin in the last bull run in 2021. 40% of the Bitcoin in circulation, 40%, crazy, are bought at $43,000. And that's what we know. So that's why we know how the market react now, like it's reacted. Because people are newbies, they're new, they're getting in crypto. Like you talked, they maybe had the wrong time. They're going in the hype because everybody's telling, oh, Bitcoin is going to 100,000. So everybody of us thinks Bitcoin is going to 100,000. And then it doesn't go. But the
most question people... is when.
These are correctly. I don't think that this is a question. If the question is when, yeah, you're absolutely right. So we're seeing this situation and we think there is a higher high. There is a new all-time high is coming because every time you have the situation, this Bitcoin is going down about 76% at the market as well. You get the next bull run and then it grows again. So, this is something what I would say in the question. Okay, we don't know what's happening now or if we take a right decision, but we don't thinking long term, and that's why we are thinking we're in a good way. And through the situation that we split and go in different parts, we think as well there's more security than be just in one coin. So we are in 5 sectors. We're doing this in a lot of sectors. We got the cash, we got the situation that we are in the mining, in DeFi, that we're in the gaming, that we're in NFTs. And I think I don't think that every part is going down. Yeah, I don't think so. And not every part is not profitable. But I think through the different parts we have, I think we are more safety, more stable for things. And so that's why we think this is a good situation. And the other thing is you're talking that we are a crypto bot. So this is something we make a situation to have it called bot, but please, the Telegram bot is not trading. This is not trading. Yeah. This is not doing the work, but people thinking, oh, my money is on Telegram and the Telegram is trading for me. No, Telegram is only a chatbot. So we're using Telegram as a communication platform. The people that you can talk to our service and you ask the server a question, what is my balance? And the servers tell you, okay, this is your balance. And it's sending through Telegram. Telegram asks and you're getting the information. And this is what we are doing with the chatbot. So this is great. And it's the same when you say invest. Okay, you push a button, invest, and the server is sending you your wallet address. And then you know, okay, this is my wallet address, and you send it. But the wallet address is on the blockchain, like you said. It's on the Bitcoin blockchain address and not on Telegram. So please.
this is not on, because there are some bots and they are doing some, there's some calculations behind. They're still doing some automatic decisions of buying, but you actually have a research team as far as I heard.
Yes.
So it's even you making the decisions, like you wake up in the morning, okay, I invest a few thousand dollars in whatnot. You have a whole team who provides you the research and then you make an educated decision.
Yeah, that's correct. So the situation is we have 3 researchers. They're doing research and every Monday we have a meeting. And then we're getting the information from them, what are new projects, what they looking for, what they think, what is a good thing. So people ask me, oh, why only just on Monday? Why not daily? Maybe interesting, because when we are invested in projects, then it's a seed phase. So that means a project we are investing takes about 9 months until a regular user use it. Because we are going in the beginnings, when the people said, I got an idea, I want to build, I need money, I sell to the first people, to the first believer. And that is the part, and this is the situation where we're looking for, okay, what's going on? What are good ideas? What is happening? And then when they're going out and said, okay, I sell the first NFT, so you can have an ownership on this product and project, then we say, okay, it's good. Let's check it. Let's have a talk all together. If one researcher checked it, let the other two check this as well, double check. And then Alexander and me talking together and looking at every project and say, okay, What do you think? What do you see the thing is changing something in the world? You think this could be something what is interesting? Okay, yes. Then mostly it's this is the good thing in the new world, I think. Yeah. Then again, you can go on Discord and then make a connection. You're just checking, okay, what's going in the Discord channel? How fast the community is growing? What they are doing? How many people are in? Are is it a review project, I think? So are the founders, show them the face? Can you see the founders? Who are the founders? Can you have a talk with them? And then you have a talk with them and see, okay, what do you want to change? What is the game and what is happening? And then you can see, okay, hey, this is interesting. We had a good research. We had a talk with the founders, if possible. So this is always the situation, or with a team member. And then we take a decision, yeah. And so, yeah, but only if both are fine. So if Alexander said, "No, Christian, I don't. That's nothing. I don't like this." Yeah, okay. Then it's over. It's the same as me. If he said it's okay, and I said, "No, I don't think there's something I don't like," then we both take a decision and said, "Okay, no, we don't do it." But the good thing is this: 10 years ago, this was not possible. 10 years ago, if you find on the market a good product, you say, wow, this is a good product. We have to buy this product, because you have to wait in half year and year to get the next product that was good as well. Yeah. But today in this crypto space, yeah, it's so crazy. Every day there is a product. Every day something new is coming out. And 1 week is like a half year in crypto. So this is because it's so much happening. It's so much happening. And this is the thing, how we go in. So this is the same. Now we're in September, we are on a conference. So we are going on the NEAR conference. They got a conference for the developer and a hackathon in Lisbon. And we're flying there, we're going there. We want to talk with the founders of the project. We want to talk with the projects they are building on this blockchain. Because why? Because it's the situation. You're finding new pimps, you're finding people, they are creating new stuff. And when you talk with them and you got the hackathons and they get rewarded for the stuff they're producing, and you talk with them and they said, "Yeah, we're building on this and this and this." Great. Then you have an alpha. You know, hey, there is something coming in the future. And this is what you need. This is the information you need to make later a 50x, 100x maybe, on a project, you know. And this is that's why we love this, and this is how we take decisions. Yeah.
And talking about founders and talking to them, a lot of times I get the question, why or how can you trust you guys, or I put in my money and what if it disappears, or the company disappears, or how can I make sure, or what is the risk of you disappearing, for example?
So the question is, yeah, it's always the same. So we have always the same questions in this part. So we got companies over 20 years. We are based in Germany. We are based in foreign lands as well, with the companies, and doing this over 20 years. So why should we take a little bit money we're getting and going somewhere? So family is here. People are children are in school, you know. You got your life. You're living your life. You got your companies. I got employees. I don't know why to leave. And you know, I want to. I have businesses over 20 years. It's like Alexander, same. He got all his businesses over years. He has another companies. I think another 3 or 4 companies as well. So I think this is, you know, we are in the daily work. So we want to have success. We want to build. We are a builder. We are a founder. We are people. We want to bring the next thing, the next thing, the next thing. Hey, what we can do? What is the next thing we love? So and that's why we're working on the project. That's why we said, no, okay, we build it up, our companies. Okay, now it's a new part, new company. Let's do this. And we love this. The last companies we gave in our heart for. And now we say, okay, this is a new project. Let's go on. And I don't know. So we show our pictures. So if you want to make, I say it like this way, if you want to make money in and wreck people in the crypto space, yeah, build a coin, make good promises and said, okay, I got a good roadmap. That's what we want to do. Yeah. Don't show your picture. Don't show your face. Yeah. And or get some actor that doing some interviews and that's it. Yeah. Cheaper, easier way. Everybody go in, tell them we'll be the next Bitcoin, and people going in and buy. Then you're making pay a little bit money to promoters, to YouTube video creators, and everything is fine. Yeah. And pay a little bit to Twitter that push every day some infos about. But this is something we don't want. But if you want this, you can money in the crypto space. If people, yeah, there are people out that they're doing this. Yeah, but we want to build something. We want to, yeah, so, want to have more people in the company.
So basically, it would be a bad business decision to rip off people this way, because it takes much more money, much more attention. You need this time to get on webinars and calls. So if you had bad intentions, it's not a good idea. There's much better ways to rip people off than building such a huge thing.
But and the question is, you know, I don't think so. So we show our pictures, we show where we are, where we're living. There are no secrets. Yeah. I don't have any secret, because, you know, when I go somewhere, we can meet us. Yeah, it's no problem. Yeah? When we're going somewhere, or we're Lisbon, or we're here or there, or wherever, we're flying to Mallorca. Everybody can meet us.
You had a presentation at the university. I missed it by 2 weeks when I was in Germany. Would I have been earlier there? I could have went there with you and Ben and Alex. So, yeah.
Yeah, it was funny because we had an invitation. So the funny is we are a company based in Malaysia. It's of the regulation. It's why Malaysia got the regulation for crypto and everything. And you got the rights to do things that are not possible now in Europe or in other countries. Yeah. And that's why we take a decision. And it's like the most companies taking the decision to going there where the regulation is good for the companies. And so we had a product and said, okay, we have a product, we can sell it out of Malaysia. And that's the good thing, what we are doing here. And then we had the invitation of the university. They said, okay, let's give us a short view and give us an information how to build a product in the universe of Web3, in the universe of crypto, in a universe where people are in the different parts of the world and working together and building up a project. Because we're all coming from a time when we were young. Okay, you had a job, you're going in a company. Everybody who works in the company was in the company. Yeah. You come in the morning and you're leaving at the night, and everybody was working, and this is the company. Yeah. Then, and now you're working in the totally different parts. People are working from home, working from Germany, working from England, from US, working in Spain and whatever, but they're all working for the same company. And this was the same in our case. We got people in the Philippines, they're working for us. So Philippines, and it was crazy to start this and tell the people, yeah, but this is working. So this is funny, because today in the morning I had a call with our community manager in the Philippines as well to ask how the week is working, how everything is in the with the gamers now, how the situation in the Philippines is, because I'm very interested what's going on there, what is going on with the people, what is the feeling about crypto, how they feel. And yeah, it's the same as everywhere in the world. It's still an not easy time there, because people are, yeah, okay. So you see, you know, there is the hype. Everybody's in, and everybody talks to you. Yeah, are you in? Are you in? Are you in crypto? And now it's more so, okay, I was in. Yeah, maybe it's coming again. And okay, let's have a regular job now. And and yeah, maybe I invest a little bit, but it takes a little bit. And so this is very funny, because it's always the same. And this is why we're thinking we are in the best in the best position we ever had. This is a pole position, what we think. This is like you have a Formula One car and you got the pole position. Because everybody behind you don't think in crypto, don't think that the space is growing again. It's always the same. They say, no, it makes no sense. No, no, just leave me alone. No, 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 no. I don't want. And everybody of us is in the first line. And we're saying, great. We see this is a huge space. Gaming getting huge. We're seeing all the big players coming in. Maybe you heard the information last week. We have a new crypto whale. There was a crypto whale bought 130,000 Bitcoin. 130,000 Bitcoin, third largest address now, a new wallet. Nobody knows who this guy is coming from. So maybe it's BlackRock because they started then and said, okay, want to build up our own phone. We don't know. So this is strange. So it's $3 billion in crypto, and this is crazy. So I think this was
BlackRock or Vanguard. This is just pocket money.
And this is the situation what we are seeing. So there are people, they coming in the space, but nobody's talking about it. They do it, but everybody's still afraid. And I think so. We are all in the pole position, and this is something what we love with our project, that we say, okay, let's get in, let's start getting money in, let us take a position, let us start, let us build, let us be there. And in 6 months, in 9 months, things are going ready. Things will be played out. Games are launching. All the stuff what we are doing. And this is what people have to believe, because I'm getting sometimes the question, oh, you're now still here 4 months. How many months you got left? What left? Yeah. Regulates takes about 6 months. Then it's over. Yeah, why? No, we're starting. We have another 5-10 years. I don't know. This is funny, because the people, sometimes we're asking us why they're asking all the things, because we're thinking in the long term. And sometimes it's crazy. We're building, buying stuff, going in mining, that you can see, hey, it's 3 years, it's 5 years. We're doing this. And people are asking when it's over. So this is funny. So for
good question. Yeah, it's weird for you because you have a different mindset. You're thinking you want to learn how to fish, not to get some fish. You want to invest for the long term. You want to invest in assets, not in just some drag and drops. And yeah, that's for some people, it's just a mindset they can get their heads around. Yeah. And you were talking about investments and the investment in Profit Wallet via the Telegram app. If you push the pay in, you have to do it with Bitcoin. So you have to invest Bitcoin. Why not dollars? Or why not euros?
That's very easy. It's a thing. First, it's a thing of regulation, because it's the situation that not in every country you're able to getting money. So when you're being Europe and you're getting euro from your clients, you need to have special licenses in every country, and this is a huge situation to getting the license, getting all the allowance to do this. And that's what we don't need in the crypto space. So that means if you don't take SEPA, so in Europe SEPA, so you're taking fiat money here, what's coming in the system, you don't need these licenses. And that's why we or just in the gateway, just in Bitcoin, yeah. Because Bitcoin in, Bitcoin out, you don't have any problem with governments and go. So, and the second thing is we have the situation that we are going from Bitcoin. Bitcoin is going to everywhere, and we're using the Bitcoin, we're changing the Bitcoin, and then we're going in Ethereum because we need Ethereum to buy some NFT, or we go in a Polygon, or we go in AVAX, or we go in Solana, or we go in Tether, where we need it. And Bitcoin is something what you can change in everything. And so this is a very good gateway. And the other thing is, Bitcoin is one of the largest coins we got in the space. And we believe that that Bitcoin is a strong asset, and that's why we we take the money in a strong asset, because we said, okay, if the price is going up and down, it's not so hard for us. So we got ups and downs in the market, but we have to be sure that we have something that is not too volatile. Yeah, so that's what we think. And euro dollar, yeah, we see we have inflation numbers. They are great, yeah. 7-8% a month. I don't know. This is crazy. But yeah, it's a different story. Yeah.
And you're keeping, you're investing in different platform, different blockchains, different coins, and so on. We hear a lot about hacker attacks, and even on the games, play to earn games, and so on. What is your security? What are your security measures? How can we ensure that the money is safe with you?
So the situation is the following. We got a security situation at the back. So that means when you're putting money in your wallet, it's your personal only wallet where you can get in. So this is, you got your personal wallet. So that means not everyone can get your personal wallet. So that means if someone is hacking, then it's hacking maybe this one wallet and not every wallet. So if they hack a wallet, there is nothing on the wallet, because when you paid in on your personal wallet, we take the money and take it out, because we just have a small portion of the money in a wallet to do the payouts. Yeah, so that means if we got, you saw the picture I showed you, the 25%. So this, from this 25%, just a small part of the 25% are really in the system for a payout situation. Yeah, because we know we don't want to have the 25% in the system to do a payout. So that means we got these on different parts, security parts, so that nobody can get to this situation. So we got ledgers and all the stuff, so that this is safe. And yeah, I don't know. That's what we can say. We don't give the money to external companies. Yeah. This is something what is very important for us. So now we got a situation, we got all the money for us. So that means we taking decision where we go in. We got the different wallets, we got the different situations. And that's why we take an eye on this. So I think we got a good. Excuse me?
So you're not keeping all the money in the same place for once, and you're not keeping those on some other platform?
No. So we got a lot of wallets. We got a lot of structure where everything is. So this is, we don't want to have a risk to put all in one wallet maybe or something, you know. So that's why we are on different exchanges and different things where you all do the daily work. So it's not possible on a different. It's not better. I would say it. So there's a security. We take care of that this happens to a lot of wallets, to a lot of ledgers and co. And I think on this way we are safe. So this is like we buy NFTs. The NFTs we're holding for long. We buy it and bring them on a ledger and hold it for long, so that nobody can go on our side or go not on our side, go on MetaMask and try to catch this or hack it. Yeah. So I think we done this good, but it's a main focus to look on security. So you could security on our side and also security on the side of the user. That's why we got in the bot the situation that you can use 2FA, the Google Authenticator, to secure your app, that nobody can do a payout if you don't want. Yeah. So that's what is for me very important.
We had a questions regarding the future of the blockchain and the system and the investment, but I think we already answered those, because this is just the beginning and a lot of new technologies coming out, and there's a lot of stuff which you could invest in and which are in the starting phases, so you can have big gains. I think the last question would be regarding the team and the building of a team, because yeah, it's a referral system, and why would you need it, or why there's the need for multiple levels, or why build in such a motivation in the first place?
Yes, so I think there are different things how to build companies, and the question is always what you want. So you can build a company in one situation. You can hire people. You let them work for your company. So that means when you're based in somewhere in a land, you need people. They work for you, and they're going out and finding people and doing sales. This is one situation you can do. The second situation is to say, okay, we're going out and we're going outside and doing advertisements. So that means that we're doing a Twitter advertisement, or you go in Google or somewhere, and spending money to find people that use your product or this way. The third way is to say, okay, let's find people. They love the product, and they say, okay, I want to share what I got as a good experience, and I share this with someone else. So this is what we're thinking. So this is a user management. We call this. We don't think that this is an level marketing or something. Yeah, we say, okay, if we got people, they are happy and they want to share that they are happy. Yeah, it's good that they can share with other people, and so they get a part of that what we are earning. And that's the way we take a decision, because we don't want to hire people, getting people on the payroll, because if you got people on your payroll, you have to pay them. If you're a good business, is the business bad? If they're ill, if they're not ill, you know, you need it in every country. I think this is a lot of money you have to pay. And when you do this, I think it's not possible to grow in this way we do it now. I don't think it's possible to pay the results we're paying, because you got a huge package of costs for your personnel. And I know it because I got companies where I had in the main time 360 people. So I can tell you, this is a lot of money you pay every month to the people, and taxes and health insurance and all the stuff what's around it. This was something where we said, no, we don't want a different way. And I think a way to talk about a good project is nothing bad. It's a good thing. So when you're going to America and you see that the most products are sold on this way, yeah, I think it's a good situation. Yeah, the question is always, and that's why you're asking for, because the most time people asking us these questions is, are your snowball system or something, you know what I mean? So because this is the question after this, because the most people say, yeah, the most people see, oh, there is when people are selling with refer somewhere else, because I think this is regular to refer somewhere else. If you got a TV, you got a TV, payment TV, you can give this to your friend. And if he's ordered this, yeah, you're getting 1 month free. I think this is regular. If you're going to some restaurants and give your friend a tip and said, okay, let's go to eat there, hey, you're getting $10 for the next time you're going there for eating. Yeah, I think this is regular to give.
It's basically affiliate marketing.
Yeah, I think this. Yeah,
whole
this,
industry, Amazon is growing through affiliate marketing. The systems.
Yeah, so this is a part of sharing information and goods. So that's what we'll be seeing. And when people asking us about you said now, I think the question is, why are people a snowball system or Ponzi or whatever? So they're using the money from the people to pay old people. And that's what they are doing. And that's what we are not doing, because we're doing one thing. We just pay out what we earn. So that's it. That's why we got the results that we have. So if we earn money, then we can pay out. And if we don't earn money, yeah, there are first results or other results that we have it now. That's the way it is. And that's why we have a lot of people. We had talks with people that said, hey, I want to join. I want to be a part. I want to do sales for you. And I love what you're doing. You're great guys. Good idea. Everything is great. But one thing is not good. So what is not good? I don't earn money. Oh, okay. Why? I need more money. So you have to pay me more. And we said, no, we can't. Don't you earn money? Yeah, we earn money, but we give it to the people. Okay. But I want more. Yeah. So you can't work with us. Why I can't work with us? Yeah, because we can't pay out what we're earning. That's it. And that's why I always tell this story, because we had people that coming to us and ask for it. We said, no, it's not possible. And we don't want this. We just give out what we're earning. And that's why we have the system to say the investor gets the money. And if there was someone who bring us the investor, then he gets a small part as well. And this every day, the investor and the investor's money is here. If the investor is leaving and the money is leaving, you don't getting anything on this money because it's away. Point. And I think this is fair, because earning money with money that's in the system, if this the money leaving the system, you don't earn on this money. Point. And we don't pay you for this. And we just pay what is earned a day, not in front. So this is another situation why a lot of companies outside have a small horizon of of life, because they bringing people, then they getting 10, 20%, 30%, 40% from the money they bringing will be paid out to the sales. And then they got maybe 60%, and with the 60% on the side, they need to do money. They have to do results. They have to give the investor money back. So this can't work. And this is what we think. And so we think this can't work. Sometimes should working, and it's good, but we don't. It's not our way. You know what I mean?
It works. It works for a short while. It's not a long time strategy for success.
So I don't know. So the question is, and maybe I'm very hard. I don't want to talk bad about other projects. So maybe this is not our way. We don't want to go and say this project is this and this, because this brings no one anything. Yeah. But I think people have to think about. So just look at the pictures, look at the numbers, just look what they are doing. And if a project say, hey, you're a great guy, I come to me to Dubai and I make a big party with you, I pay you the flight, I pay you a hotel, I pay you everything, and you have a good time and everything is fine. So who pays this? Is the company paying this? No, the investor is paying this, because the people paying in money in the system, and from this money this will be paid. Point. And if it can't be different, yeah? Or I don't know, what are you thinking? But I think, someone is paying this, and someone has to earn this.
Diamond level bars and trips, and they have to come from somewhere. This money has to come from the system. Yeah. And the system is made up of all the money and products people are bringing in. Yeah. So, yeah.
Yeah. And that's what I think. I think so. This is my idea, and the idea from Alexander. So we want to have a benefit for everyone, but don't use money from anyone to pay something you don't earn. And that's, I think this is the situation. Yeah,
it's good to have new money, because then you can make new investments.
Sure,
you don't need it in order to function, in order to fulfill the investors and so on.
Yes.
So it's a good thing, but it's not a must-have. You don't depend on new money entering the system.
Yes.
Yeah. It's already much, much, much later than I was expecting. I had the time, but I know you're very occupied and you have a lot of other meetings to attend to. So thank you very, very much for your time and your great inputs. And we answered, I hope, a lot of questions people had and will have. And just everybody else, just go to the website, look into the project, look up these great guys here, I will post some contact data in the description of the video. You can contact us, ask us any questions. If I can answer them, I know Christian and Alex are there to help us out. There's a support in the system which you can write to. So yeah, basically it's a great system. I trust it. A lot of my partners and great friends are trusting it. So yeah, thank you very much. And if you have some last words, perhaps. And then I think we can close up.
Yeah, sure. Thank you for your time. So I would say it was a long interview today, but we want to take the time. So that's very important for us, because I think one thing what is missing in the space is trust, and trust is the thing what we really want to build. Because I think a lot of things are not running very good the last years for different projects, different things, space, whatever. I think a little bit Wild West. And I think we want to give the people hope, the opportunity to say, okay, there are different things as well. And we want to have the trust. We say, thank you that you give us the trust and say, okay, let's try it. Let's move it. Let's build something together. And this is something what we love, that we got an idea. We want to make this larger and want to grow with you. And you say, well, we love this journey. We love what you're doing, how you do this, how you're thinking, how we are on the long term as well, not only short term investors. Then we love you, that you're going on this journey with us. And I think this is what I can say to everyone. If you take a decision and say, okay, I'll be on board, I think this is a life-changing situation what you will have, but not if you just go in for 1 month, for 2 months, or 3 months, because we all need the time. We all need the time to build. And I think if you want to build for your success, and a small part of the money you want to invest in this idea, take it and leave it and do it 5 or 10 years. Point. And then you will have life-changing money. That's what I think. But take this part you like, and don't get in all in. You know, I think this is not the right situation, yeah, to go all in. But take a small part, test us, see what we are doing. And if you like it, what we do, yeah, you can do more. Or what you like, what you want to do your own research. And I think then we may be a good part of your portfolio. That's what I say. Yeah. Thank you for your time. And yeah.
Thank you very much. Looking forward to meeting you in person. We sure. Just saw each other in live calls. And yeah, great guy, great project, great company. Hope to hear you soon and see you soon. Yeah. Have a great day. Thank you for your time.
Bye-bye.
Bye, Christian.
Bye-bye.